Hi guys, in last video we saw that how we can perform binary search on a list of numbers which are sorted. So we saw that the list which we provided to the function was already sorted, which means that numbers were in the ascending order, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, something like that. But in real world, what happens that whatever the data you get is not sorted. It is actually some random numbers in some random orders, and whenever you have to perform such kind of search, let's say binary search, then you have to sort it. So sorting is an algorithm which has a lot of applications. So in this program, we are going to perform a such sorting algorithm known as a bubble sort. It is a very easy algorithm. I will tell you how to. I will tell you the exact algorithm, and you can use the algorithm to write your own program. We'll write the program for bubble sort also. So let's see this. Let me first give you an array. So let us assume we have an array of size 5, and the elements are 5, 1, 4, 2. So what I want to sort the elements of this array. It means the final array should look like 1, 2, 4, 5, and 8. So bubble sort is like that. So in first loop, what I will do, so I will have two loops exactly. So in first iteration, what I have to do, I will compare the first two elements and see whether the first element is less than the second element or not. If it is not, if the first element is not less than second element, then I will swap their position. So here 5 is not less than 1, so I will swap. So 1 should come before 5, so it will become 1, 5. Now I will move to the next two elements, which are 5 and 4. So I'll go there, I will compare them and see the same thing, which is if 5 is less than 4, then it is okay. Otherwise, I will swap them. So 5 is not less than 4, so I have to swap them. So it will become 4 and 5. Now I will move to the next two elements, which are 5, 2. Again, I will perform the same. I will check the same condition. So 5 is not less than 2, so I will swap them. So it becomes 2, 5. I'll move to the next two elements, same condition. Since 5 is less than 8, I don't have to swap them. So my array, the first loop is over. I'll go to the second loop, I mean the second iteration. In second iteration, again I will compare the first two elements. So I'm doing the same thing. So you can find the pattern here. In the first loop, inside the first loop, I must have another loop. In that loop, I should do all those things. And whenever the second, whenever the first iteration of the first loop gets over, the second instance come, I will do the second again perform the same thing. So again I will compare the first two elements, so 1 and 4. Since 1 is less than 4, I don't have to swap anything. I'll move to the second two elements. 4 is not less than 2, so I have to swap them. So 2 comes before 4, it becomes 2, 4. I'll move to the next two elements. 4 is less than 5, so I don't have to swap anything. Now next two elements, 5 is less than 8, I don't have to swap anything. So after this, my array is sorted. So I need exactly something like that, 1, 2, 4, 5, 8. So now you know the algorithm. I gave you a simple basic idea of the algorithm. I am not writing a pseudocode kind of thing. We will use this idea to write the program. It's a very simple program, and I think that anyone can write it. So we'll see in the next video.